Blackstone Publishing presents The Man in the Glass House, Philip Johnson, Architect of the Modern Century, by Mark Lamster. This book is read by Mark Bramhall. For John Manley and Robert Melick Finkel. I can't stand truth. It gets so boring, you know, like social responsibility. Philip Johnson. Prologue. You cannot know history. Philip Johnson issued that famous maxim in 1959, and though he was talking about architectural tradition, he could just as well have been speaking about his own rich life, which was then barely past its halfway point. That life began in 1906 and ended in 2005, and he spent just about all of the 98 years in between stirring up trouble. There is hardly a city in America that is not graced, or fouled, by a building with Johnson's name on it, and often more than one. He craved attention and made himself into a genuine celebrity. He was the architect of the imagination, a familiar face in his owl-frame glasses, a debonair, self-deprecating wit with a quip for every occasion. His story, however, is much more than one of a charismatic man and his uneven architecture. Johnson lived the American century, and his story mirrored the nation's epic trajectory in that time. It opened with the highest aspirations and ambitions, embracing the possibilities of a modern world, yet concluded by abetting the accumulation of vast power and influence by a select few. His story, like the American story, was one of darkness as much as light, a story of inequity and bigotry, of the perils of cynicism, of human weakness and venality, of rampant corporatism, of the collapse of wealth and authority into the hands of a plutocratic class. Philip Johnson began his career proselytizing the public in the name of modern design. He finished it building for Donald Trump. We cannot know Philip Johnson's history because it is our history, like it or not. His dozens of works range in quality from the nadir of grim opportunism to the apex of civic and architectural achievement, but either way, they shape our skylines, our streetscapes, and our daily lives. Johnson's buildings are ubiquitous, but his influence far exceeds their mere presence. He was a shaper not just of individual structures or even of cities, but of American culture. When his interest first turned to architecture as a young man in the 1920s, modernism was an esoteric movement confined mostly to industry, social progressivism, and the occasional luxury residence. By the time of his death, the modern, with its sharp forms and sharp materials, was the defining language of the American city, the vernacular of business, and the default aesthetic of the avant-garde and the cultural aristocracy. He was not fully responsible for that shift, but he played an instrumental part in it. His career began not as an architect, but as a curator and a critic. Johnson was the founding director of the architecture department of the Museum of Modern Art and one of its most important patrons. His gifts of painting and sculpture, works by Jasper Johns, Paul Klee, Roy Lichtenstein, Mark Rothko, Oscar Schlemmer, Andy Warhol, define that institution and its narrative of 20th century art. But it was in architecture and design that Johnson exerted greatest influence. His landmark exhibitions established the way design is presented and understood, that both everyday objects and grand works of architecture are worthy of veneration. More critically, he used his platform at the museum to promote a controversial vision of what modern architecture could and should be, a modernity that was about form and style rather than the values that good design could promote, affordable, healthy, and environmentally sensitive building and planning that edified the private and public realms. When he tired of modernism, he ushered in its rejoinder, postmodernism. And when he saw that as a dead end, he reframed the field once again. Johnson craved the attention that came with these reversals. He had a Barnum-esque gift for publicity.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.